давайте еще раз поаплодируем и встретим Дмитрия. Расскажем в процессе вашего визита, что сегодня ждет ваших поклонников вечером. Пожалуйста, хорошо вам слово.
Well, this is the 25th anniversary of the original release. And we've had good experiences playing Moscow before, and we thought this would be a perfect opportunity to end the tour here tonight. So this is closing night.
Значит, 25 лет альбому Crimson Idol. У нас не первый раз приезжаем в Россию, всегда все нравилось. И мы решили, что будет отличным местом для завершающего концерта всего тура.
Друзья, чтобы не тратить наше время, давайте сразу перейдем к вопросам. Если у вас есть вопросы к нашему гостю, подходите заранее к микрофону, не забывайте представляться, называть ваши СМИ. Блэйки, расскажите, пожалуйста, какие сюрпризы на сегодняшнем концерте мы подготовили для российской публики? Пожалуйста.
We're doing something with this that is very different. We are literally bringing a movie to a rock show. And we've never seen anyone do that before. It's kind of like in the old days where you had a silent movie and then maybe a piano player came out or a small band or something like that. This is an old concept, remodernized with a rock band in front of it. So they're literally going to see a feature motion picture with a rock band standing in front of us.
Не знаю, насколько это сюрприз, мы практически будем показывать кино, в некотором смысле, как старый оригинальный, немая картинка, а с ней татур или какая-то небольшая музыкальная группа. Значит, а сегодня мы будем делать то же самое, только в рок-исполнении. Будет целое шоу.
Спасибо. Ваш вопрос?
Да, hello, my name is Victoria. It's a pleasure to see you here.
Thank you.
And the question about 13 years ago you were playing first time in Russia. It was to 24. And you were playing the Neon God. And now you're playing here Crimson Idol. In 1989, you released Headless Children, and the bonus track song was War Cry. Can you remember this song? And there were lyrics that I was marked from the day I was born. And my father could not understand the fire burning in me. And there is a story when you were young and you were watching TV with your family, and there was your father, and you saw Alice Cooper performing there, and you said, "That's my thing. I will do this." So, is it really the topic you want still to discuss about young teenagers, about teenagers who are seeking for love of their parents?
I've never had an adversarial relationship with my parents. Always had a good relationship with my parents. But I kept getting asked one question more than any other from the fans. They would say, "Hey, give me some advice. How do I get from where I am to where you are?"
Дайте мне совет, как мне попасть, как мне пройти вот оттуда, где я сейчас нахожусь, туда, где вы сейчас.
So I would tell them how difficult it is to do this for a living. It's really hard. And they would listen, and they'd go, yeah. And it would go through one ear and out the other. And I thought, these kids aren't hearing a word I'm saying. So I thought, I'm going to write a story, and I'm going to show them the reality of what the music business is, not the life. Not this. I'm going to show them the reality of what it is. And then once they've heard that story, they think they still want to do it, go ahead.
Они часто задают этот вопрос, я рассказываю, отвечаю, они говорят «да-да-да», но в одном улетает, в другом улетает. И ничего там так не вернется. Поэтому я решил написать песню, написать целый проект, рассказать им не про свет, не про славу, а про то, как это действительно, как тяжело это. И если они прослушали, поняли и все еще хотят этим заниматься, может, вперед.
But as you said a few years ago, the main change happened between now and then. So now there is no musical industry as well.
Right.
So what would you tell now to these people who want to...
I have no idea. I really don't. I'm not trying to be funny. I mean, I look at my manager, Ross Smallwood, we were in the UK. I mean, he manages us, Iron Maiden. We were having this conversation 6 weeks ago, and somebody asked him, how to get a new band off the ground. His response was, he goes, I have no clue. I mean, this is someone managing one of the biggest bands in the world right now, and we don't know how to do it.
Сейчас музыкальная индустрия настолько изменилась, что даже менеджер, которого они делают вместе с Iron Maiden, когда задают такой вопрос, как сейчас раскрутить группу, он и понятия не имеет.
When somebody figures it out, let us know.
Does news agency, Mr. Black here, it's been 25 years since the original album was released. Now, 25 years later, how do you perceive your work as a writer? Are you completely satisfied with it? And if yes, why did you decide to re-record it? And how the new version, re-idolized, differ from the original album?
We re-recorded it because it was contractual obligation to do it for the soundtrack for the film. Contractually, we had to do that. Contractually, we had to do that because we could not do it. We could not use the original recordings.
Во многом зависит от... Если нам по контракту пришли сделать, то почему они за авторские права?
I don't know. Most writers feel that they're never finished with what they do. I'm not one of those people. I can usually look at something and know when it's finished. And to me, that story is finished. You're always going to have periods where, like in Hollywood, we use an expression in the movie industry where you flesh out a character. You flesh them out. That means you really start to understand who they are. You give them a history and a background and things like that. So maybe some of that stuff is changing my head, but that's just me as a creator. That really has nothing. I don't even think the audience would.
Есть некоторые авторы, которые всю жизнь работают на одной и той же истории, пишут ее, дописывают, додумывают, и они из таких, я считаю, эту историю законченной. Но настолько глубоко мы прожили, что мы написали какую-то историю за каждого из персонажей, своей истории, то есть она уже такая глубокая. Так.
And how does it differ from the original, re-idolized? Is it an extended?
It sounds like more of a movie soundtrack, really, to be honest with you. When we were doing it, the first thing I did is I went in the studio and I listened to the old 2-inch tapes. And it was pretty intimidating because the first thing I thought was, how do I do this again? So, when we re-recorded it, we did about 5 test mixes before we found the sound. And it wasn't me, and I wish I could tell you that it was all part of a big idea that we have, but it was more of an accident than anything, because Logan Mader is the guy that was mixing it, and when he came up with this, what sounded like a movie soundtrack, I said, that's it, that's the direction we'll go.